Hello, my love bugs. Welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me today. I know it's been quite some time since I've been before you. You know, well, life has been lifing, you know. Got a little sick, has done some traveling, and so we're here with not necessarily a relationship or a dating topic, but I definitely want to address a matter amongst our black or beautiful brownies, beautiful brown sisters, that I feel has been a bit of a stigma for some time. Okay, so I thank you for joining me today. Welcome back. And so I, as I stated, I've been traveling. And so at one of the particular airports while I'm waiting, you know, you people watch or whatever, and me being a relationship coach, I tend to notice couples, you know, that sort of thing. It's natural, kind of like a dentist to teeth. Yeah. So as I'm sitting and waiting, I notice a Middle Eastern couple that they come and they sit, not necessarily together, like close, like a couple. And, you know, me, I'm always studying all types of couples and behaviors and that sort of thing. And I can immediately tell when a couple isn't closely connected. There's a disconnect. There's, you know, not a whole lot of happiness. You know, it's easy for me to detect, considering I've been doing this for quite some time now. So it's quite easy for me. And as I'm just observing, you know, off and on certain things that were actually more prevalent or noticeable, I should say, with the wife. You know, she was in her, you know, ensemble that they typically wear. But you can still, by the demeanor, that something was amiss. And I would assume that that was love. And so while I'm sitting, guys, I have a hyperactive mind. And the wheels began to turn and my thoughts began to deepen. And you know, I like to go deeper, guys, on any topic. I like to get down to what really is, just so we can make it all make sense. And so I'm thinking, like, why are most Middle Eastern women typically married? And I'm just thinking, you know, that thought and then other things. And then it's like I had an epiphany. Like, wait a minute, whoa. So it has been stigmatized that black women are the least to marry, and if she does, it's much later in life. I would say late 30s, probably even 40s, right? And so, and I'm thinking, why is that? Like, is that really true? But then I really began to make an assessment. And I began to think about how marital culture and customs are in Western society versus Eastern, you know, cultures, and just brought it in as a whole. So I'm thinking about us here in the Western civilization. You know, we kind of, you know, do what it is that we like to do. We kind of roam freely, don't necessarily have a custom. You know, hell, we can go and get married within 24 hours, but after getting drunk with someone, and it's totally fine. You know, we're kind of reckless over here. You know, ones, you know, they may say from the Eastern culture that we're uncouth and tactless, and we do things, you know, a little less organized or, you know, structured. And so, yes, that's that's partly true for most of us who are not like super religious, that sort of thing. And so when I was thinking about Caucasian women, how they have that privilege of actually marrying, they could marry multiple times and not be criticized for it. You know, you take Elizabeth Taylor, I think she had like 7 marriages. Oh, she was seen as like the queen of having a husband. Or it's like because they have that opportunity, especially if they are not necessarily high society, but has always lived a prominent lifestyle, or, you know, in a group or a community to where you can easily meet someone who's well established. They have the same mindset and goals as you do. So it's easy for them to say, oh, hey, Mary, here's my brother. You know, he's in engineering, da 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 da. And they meet 2 years later, they're married. you know? So it's quite different for Black women, because most of us come from the hood. The guys we typically date are from the hood, regardless if they're educated or not, but they still have that same relationship or dating mindset, you know? So it kind of limits us. Hell, even Katie from Alabama, like the backwoods of Alabama, she can actually have two options, you know, Billy Bob or Buster on the other side of the woods. You know, she actually has choices. So it's very, I guess it's more convenient for Caucasian women to just marry. They can marry anyone multiple times. And then, yes, it's very easy, accessible for them to find a mate, even if it isn't long term. But for us, we are seen as someone who is hard to get along with. We always have attitudes, perhaps present, or maybe not as much as you should have been, and wasn't there to tap you on the shoulder and say, no, that's not the guy you need to be with. You know, because most dads have that intuition of what men, what their motives are. So you may not have had that. Otherwise, you wouldn't have been with 3 or 4 or 5 guys trying, soul searching, trying to find the one, because it always seems as though with Black women, we're up against a clock, like a time. When you hit 30, you begin to panic. Okay, I'm not married yet. I haven't had my first child, or I've had my first child, but I had it out of wedlock. I want to do things right this next time around. And you know, it's like you're always up against time. And it's because we're limited. You know, I don't want us to think like we're limited mentally, but the reality of it is our options are kind of slim. And that's why I always encourage you guys to think outside of the box, you know. But here's what I discovered or learned while I was thinking. So it's not necessarily that these other women and other ethnicities and races are better than we are, more educated, more beautiful. You want to know what it is, loves? It is because the majority, and I say the majority of them, let's go Eastern, have been in prearranged marriage, like, you know, India, Africa, Asia. You know, they have been in prearranged marriage since they were very young, especially in Africa. They train the girl to be a certain way, to the liking to the guy, which is usually much older, to whatever it is that he is going to want in a wife, which means it just strips them of all of their identity. So they never get a chance to enjoy life and say, oh, I like this and I like doing this. No. It becomes all about their future husband from a very young age. Like even in Romania, like the little gypsy girls, they are usually married between the ages of 16 and 18 because they've already had, not necessarily someone chosen for them, but if they have to meet a guy, let's say in the community, in their neighborhood, then the parents get together and they plan this wedding for X amount of years. And when they reach those ages, they marry. So, if you want to say that Black women are less likely to marry because of X, Y, and Z, that's not true, not at all. The reason is because those other cultures are usually prearranged. They're like dowries and an exchange that is done, like over a long period of time. And I promise you, my loves, majority of those women are not happy. They have to be submissive. They have to be a certain way. I don't know if you've seen the movie Woman King. The young girl in the very beginning, she was trying to get away from her parents because they were trying to train her to be with some older guy who I think he abused her or something like that. And so she ran away. And then, you know, that whole, so yes, that's what it is. It's not because they're better than us or something's wrong with us. It is because they are already, they already had their mate chosen for them, their life partner. That's why. And see, society, they would put these numbers in these charts and, oh, Asian women, this amount of women, they're like 70% of them are married and they've been married for X amount of years, and make it seem as like we're just, and that's simply not the case. Think about it. Now, it's a little different with the Hispanic and Latin culture because they not necessarily take their time getting married. Spanish women, well, they choose love and romance is for the most part like secondary. All right. For those type of women, to my knowledge, it's all about living well, living a certain lifestyle. Okay. My husband needs to have a degree. If not, he needs to have his own business. I want this and I want that. I actually work with Hispanic sister when I was working for a Fortune 500 company. And so it was the weekend. I was like, so what are you going out this week? Oh, no, boo. I'm taking my husband, unbeknownst to him, out to the country so we can look for a house with acres of land. Because I want chickens and I want some pigs to start. And so that's what we're doing this weekend. And he's going to be pissed because he just bought me a brand new truck. And that's what it is for them. A lifestyle. So love is kind of like secondary, you know. He can work his ass off. But, you know, as long as he brings me what I need when I come home, it's kind of that sort of thing. Romance, that sort of thing. So think about it. And those women that are married, I guarantee you, are not happy at all. And so I got all of that just from observing that couple and how she just seems so disconnected. He's on his phone like he's having a good time and she's just sitting there just staring out, wishing she could just fly away to some unknown place. And I felt bad for her. Or maybe, I don't know, but that's the energy I picked up. I'm really good with energy and that's what I was sensing. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with you all. So, are Black women less likely to marry? If that is true, it is because we have, well, look what's out there. You know, it's like you have to kiss a million frogs just to get to someone who's actually just suitable. You know? And no, I'm not married. I've never been married. I was in a 20-year relationship with my best friend. And I encourage any of you out there, never marry your best friend. I was very young. But you never do that. And I never saw that in our future. I never really saw marriage in my future with anyone. You know, I've always just wanted to have a career, live life, travel, have fun, as I'm doing now. So that's what I've seen for myself. Now, I'm not going to rule it out. If a guy who's brave enough and he's going to do what it is that he needs to do, I'm no nonsense type of person. I don't believe in second chances. Like, you just need to be right. Okay. Yeah. So that's that. Yeah. So let me know your thoughts on what you think about this whole stigma about Black women being the lowest on the totem pole to marry. And we're just not, you know, that sort of worthy of. Okay. Leave your comments down below. If you need coaching or dating advice, all of my information will be linked down below. I thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you to all of my new subscribers. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Feel free to reach out to me anytime. Again, all of my information is linked down below. That is all for now, my loves. Until next time.